Rwanda's quest to digitize her economy has led to the creation of various digital platforms. The African Continental Free Trade Area AFCFTA agreement that is set to be in operation from June 2020 presents a lot of opportunities in e-commerce and fintech for Rwanda.
I think companies like Comsa and even other IT companies are now in a position where they will be able to participate in the development of various e-government solutions to facilitate this trade that is going to take place.
Keza Bunyenyezi, founder and director of Comsa, sees free trade as an opportunity for tech companies to offer e-services to their governments.
As IT companies, we're able to facilitate this cross-border movement. We have an e-visa platform that allows people to process their visas and then get visas on arrival. And these are some of the things that, you know, we'd like to see more of instead of 5 to 14 day visa processing times that we are seeing in some of the countries on the continent today.
Comsa has grown from an airtime credit service to one of the biggest micro lenders in Africa. Rwanda envisions itself becoming a regional ICT hub and has committed to making the most out of technology to enhance service delivery.
The time it takes to take the product to market. So we used to spend weeks, months to take a product to market, but due to some advances in technology, it's now take lesser time to take a new product to market.
In Rwanda, digital transformation is positioned as a critical enabler for the country's development agenda. As such, companies like MTN Rwanda are leveraging on big data and artificial intelligence to gain more insights into their customers' needs and behaviors, which drives their purchase decisions.
The demand is also changing. We're competing in another space. I mean, as mobile operators, we're moving from just a core business provider, meaning voice and data, into more a digital service provider.
With growth comes the big challenge for telecommunication firms like MTN Rwanda to keep updating their technology capabilities. Comsa also felt this challenge.
In the past, the change from 1G to 2G, it took 20 years. And that was only a change from, I think, less than 2.4 kbps to 144 kbps. It took 20 years. From 2G to 3G, it took 10 years, less than 10 years. And from 3G to 4G, it took a maximum of 5 years. And now we're also talking about 5G. So the trend is really growing faster. And as service provider, we are also required to be more innovative, to come up with new products and move away from competing within the traditional business.
Rwanda has not been left behind in the global trend towards greater data privacy. Telecommunication providers like MTN Rwanda and Comsa have to keep upgrading systems to cope with security threats.
We keep educating our consumer, our customers, in terms of their own security, assuring their own security. An example that I can give, mobile money or MFS fraud is something that is becoming a concern to the public. We do collaborate a lot with the regulator, so we put in place frameworks that ensure safety and security of our subscribers, as well as their privacy, and we also collaborate with different government agencies.
Rwanda, Uganda, Kenya, and Ethiopia are among the countries that have ratified the free trade agreement. The tech companies in this region will benefit from the exposure to more African companies and help them spread their impact.
There have been major advancements and investments in making sure that the IT companies on the continent are equipped to provide solutions for the challenges that we are living, that we are facing. We have developed the technologies to deliver services at a global standard.